You know how dad is teaching us how to drive? What did you learn up to? Did you learn how to park?
I almost crashed the car last time. I was went into a wall.
She literally almost crashed the car. Dad was like, stop. Stop.
No, he did not.
Yes, he did.
He was like, stop, and I stopped the car.
My personality is goofy too. Like, I like to make people laugh. When I don't have competition, I can go out. Like I go out with my friends, I go out with my sisters.
You guys want to go like I want to go close to the water.
Outside of, you know, the boxing world, she's outgoing, she's loving, she's very friendly, she makes a friend very quick.
That one's good. That one's good.
Love it. You used to love Justin Bieber. You used to sing his song, Baby, all the time.
That was the song.
Not him. Okay, but still, you have that song on repeat. 3. That was so bad. It was so bad. Okay, ready? Come on, Michelle. I have to.
Go like this.
Be natural with it. Go with the flow.
When it's near competition, like about a month away from competition, I need to be focused. The tournament in December is a big tournament. And if I win in December, I go to the youth national team and I fight for my country. When COVID shut everything down, we started training at home, and it's like in a garage. And it gets hot down there. It's like training in a sauna. I had so much competition lined up for this year. It all went away because of COVID, and like that kind of discouraged me. And now I'm just like ready to be in the ring again.
From training to competing, it's night and day with her. You know, she'll have some bad days in the sparrings, but when it's time, when it's clutch time, when it matters, oh, she steps up.
When I found out that my tournament got postponed, my heart dropped. It's only a week away. Like, I was so confident that the tournament was gonna happen, and I just started crying. Like, I burst out into tears. You work so hard for something, and then it just blows up in your face, and it just, like, postponed or canceled.
When the tournament was ripped away, you know, it's like a bummer. Like, you know, you're leading up to this tournament, and you're giving it all you got. You're training your butt off. You're eating the way you're supposed to eat. And you're doing all the necessary things that's gonna crown you as a national champion again. And then that was taken away. Everything plummeted on her, like her motivation just deflated.
It was upsetting to see how hard she worked and how much effort she put into, you know, preparing for the tournament. She was ready for it. She wanted to compete.
I was having trouble like getting through to her, like, Chantel, you know, everybody is still training. We just got to stay training. This is going to make or break a lot of athletes, not only boxers, all athletes in general.
After that, I was very discouraged. But then my dad talked to me and he told me all of my hard work one day is going to pay off into one of these tournaments that one day is eventually going to happen.
You just need to bite down and keep training. You need to listen to me, trust the process. It's not only you, it's everybody. It's everybody that's been put on hold with this pandemic, not just us.
She just didn't give up. She just continued training and continued pushing herself. And this was gonna be over one day, and she's gonna be able to get back into the sport and be able to do what she loves to do.
Hopefully there is light at the end of the tunnel, because I just want to get out there and compete again, because I haven't competed in so long.